live in Southern California. This is Channel 4 News at 5:30.
American Me. It's a movie based on gang violence and a movie that is stalked by real violence and murder. Hello again, everyone. I'm Rick Chambers.
And I'm Kelly Lang.
You know, since the film's release, two technical advisors have been murdered. And now we learn that a third one has been killed. The first, you may remember, was Charles Manriquez. He was known as Charlie Brown. Then Anna Lizarraga, seen here in a scene from the movie. She was found dead. Well, now a third advisor, Manuel Luna, is also dead. Joe Rico is live in our Channel 4 newsroom with more on this bizarre series of killings. Joe.
Four murder victims, three of them people who offered their expertise into the making of American Me. It is not yet clear if last week's gang-style execution was directly related to the making of the movie, but sources say it is a clear reminder that ill feelings still persist.
53-year-old Manuel Rocky Luna was found shot to death in his car in Ramona Gardens last Friday. He had been shot three times in the upper torso at point-blank range. Police believe it was a Mexican mafia hit.
Sources say Luna was a long-standing member of the EME, or Mexican Mafia, a man who quietly downplayed his role as one of the technical advisors to the making of the movie American Me. And now with his death, he's the third person killed behind the movie. All three of them technical advisors, all three of them from this very same neighborhood known as Hazard.
Manuel Luna and I did time in San Quentin.
Sources, among them this former Mexican Mafia hitman, suggest that the murder could be in retaliation for the death of Anna Lizarraga. She was the technical advisor who also had a bit part in American Me. She was gunned down outside her Lincoln Heights home last year, shortly after the movie's release. Since Rocky Luna was from that neighborhood and in good standing with the EME, it was widely believed that he knew Lizarraga was going to be killed.
He would have to have known that the hit was going to take place if it was Mexican Mafia business. And my guess, my educated guess and an educated opinion would be that he lent a hand. He was he was connected somehow, even if it was just pointing out a residence.
Now investigators, or rather sources, say the execution could be unfinished business within the Mexican Mafia, or even a message to actor-director Edward James Olmos, who they say has an open contract out in his life for the involvement in the making of the movie. They also add that 2 weeks ago, a worried-looking Edward James Olmos walked into a San Fernando Valley police station saying that a recent state prison parolee was out to kill him. Kelly, back to you.
All right, Joe, thanks.